Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How's everybody doing? Somebody say yeah. I can't hear it. Somebody say yeah. Are you ready for star time? Are you ready to have a good time? We have a fantastic, super show for you tonight. And I want you to sit back, relax, let your hair down. If you got any, like me. You got any hair? Let your hair down. Without further ado, we bring to you the man of the hour, the one, the only. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Paul Santos.
Welcome to our show. Oh, I feel the energy tonight. I feel the energy tonight. Oh. Hey, how about that introduction by the sidekick of the century, the co-host with cachet, Mr. Chops Turner, there he is! And how about the king of the keys, he does it with ease, Gary Langevin and the Paul Santos Live Band featuring Adi DeMello!
Everybody, welcome. Thank you.
Oh my God, you know, we highlight the talented, interesting, and entertaining on the show, and we've gotten an all-star lineup tonight, starting with 22-year-old singing sensation Lexi Tebbs is in the house tonight. We also have on the show this evening a terrific singer. I think he's a little bit older than 22. I'm not sure exactly how old he is. Dana DeBarros is here tonight. And we have a tremendous individual. He knows people, he's knowledgeable, he's funny, he's a fantastic guest. Johnny Bolito in the house tonight. All right. And by the way, a shout out to our viewers out there on ABC 6 in Providence. Good Sunday morning to you. That's when they watch again on Sunday morning. If you are watching on Monday night, give us a hello through New Bedford Guide, our New Fall River reporter, because we want to interact. We want to know that you're out there, so say hello. And we'll chat with you in just a few moments. All right, let's get caught up in the news before we get to our fantastic lineup of guests. You see in the news that old smokestack in New Bedford, the eyesore, was taken down by a controlled explosion. Happened right here in downtown New Bedford. They blew it up. It went like this, and the whole smokestack went over. Yeah, you know. That smokestack, it kind of had a nickname. It was always called the cigarette stack. But I really think it looked more like a funny cigarette stack. In fact, it looked like a blunt.
Oh, you're talking my language.
You know, in England, they have Big Ben. We had Big Blunt. That's how it worked. No, but seriously, they knocked it down, and it really was an eyesore there in the old NSTAR building. It was kind of strange, though, you know. Once they lit it up for the explosion, half the people in New Bedford went down there and tried to smoke what was left of it.
That's a true story. Yes.
I see my friend Grace is choking from sustained laughter. Or is she just choking because it was so bad? I'm not sure which. You know, Gary and I, we have a lot in common, you know. Pot.
Yes.
No, it's not what you think. Gary smokes pot. I have a pot belly.
Yes, he does. That's right.
Can't get rid of this thing. I just don't understand it. I just don't understand
it. You get a pot belly pick as well.
I'm trying to get rid of mine. He's trying to keep his. Hey, you know, Chops, he used to be a man in that category, right? You know, his name is Chops Turner. He used to be known as Chops Burner. Yeah. That was a long time ago. I'm sorry, Chops. I'm sorry. Way back in the day. He's been on the wagon for 30 years. That's okay. Hey, you know, sometimes when I'm on the road, you know, people are like doing stuff and they're starting road rage with you and stuff. Don't do that. I don't do that. I'm a very laid back guy. I don't like to get involved in those things. Well, I'm coming over the Bragger Bridge in Fall River and
somebody actually waved at me and smiled. It's like that. You know, and I think I cut them off, but they just smiled at me and they waved. And they used all their fingers.
Oh, my.
But, you know, that good day didn't last too long because I went from there to a doctor's office. So I'm sitting in the doctor's office, and I'm looking through my news feed, and I see all about the jellyfish. I don't know why. I was reading about the jellyfish. And I'm looking at the jellyfish, and we all know, right, the jellyfish have no brain. You knew that, right? The jellyfish, they have no brain. So I said to the guy sitting next to me, I said, hey, do you realize that the jellyfish have no brain? And he said, yeah, well, I guess there's hope for you. That was mean. Why did he say that to me? Come on, man. So then they called me into the doctor and I waved goodbye and I didn't use all my fingers. Never mind. Sorry about that. Hippolito, how am I doing over there? Hippolito, Mike, we're supposed to be back here next week, so let me know if we're okay. My friend Grace over here said what? I should use some hand sanitizer? That way I can clean up the jokes. Hey! Hey, we're in the number one fishing port in all of America. Yes. You know, a New Bedford fishing boat down here. Hey, let's hear it for New Bedford, number one fishing port. Number one. Well, you know, a New Bedford fishing boat needs an engine. Anybody here know how much it costs to put a new engine in a fishing boat? $175,000. Imagine that. I've heard of the captain going down with a ship, but that's ridiculous. By the way, this reminds me of another captain, Captain Viagra.
Mm.
Now, let me tell you the story about that captain. He came upon hard times, and but everything's going great. He's now on a tall ship.
Oh!
Hey! All right, so let me...
We might need a dumpster for tonight's show. That bucket's not going to quite keep it.
Hey, so John said, don't go over the line. Was that over the line, or was that all right? All right, he's going to go over the line. PG. Yeah, we're doing PG. All right. Well, you know, I got to tell you, for people who didn't know, my wife and I, a couple of weeks ago, became grandparents for the first time. Oh, it was so thrilling. Yep. My handsome son, Dylan, my beautiful daughter-in-law, Stephanie, gave birth to a beautiful baby boy, Sam Santos.
Sammy Santos,
baby. That's right. Oh, we're so excited. She delivered at a hospital. But, you know, since the pandemic, more and more babies are being delivered at home. You know, it's a regular midwife crisis.
Oh.
Keep it or dump it.
Yeah.
Keep it. All right. Thank you very much. You're kind. You're very kind. I appreciate that. They know it should be dumped, but they're being very nice. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Hey, how many people here believe in UFOs? Believe that they're aliens? Huh? Yeah. How many people think it's a lot of nonsense? All right. Well, you know, I did my own Paul Santos live investigation.
Did you?
NASA has a super strong telescope that zooms right in on the alien spaceship. There was actually a little green man out there. A little green man that came from Mars. Imagine that. There was only one thing. He wasn't wearing any clothes. I guess they're going to have to put it down as a... They're going to have to put it down as an unidentified flashing object.
Oh.
Casey says dump that one. All right. Wait a minute. Let's see. What have I got? Oh, now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to make an announcement. I'm now going to deliver to you my final joke of the night. Hey, you know, I know somebody here that does taxes, works at H&R Block. Grace, we're getting a tax season, right? Yeah, we're getting a tax season. So I'm getting all these forms in the mail, all these tax documents. So I was like organizing them for my accountant. You know what my accountant is, Chops? Wanda Wages. You know, they say that there are two things in life that are certain, death and taxes. But death is easier. At least you don't have to die once a year. So I put all these documents on the table, and I'm spreading them out on the table, and I'm thinking, maybe I ought to do like Chops and work under the table. I'm telling you right now, I don't know a Form 140 from Route 140. So you know what I did? I got drunk and decided to do my own taxes. I'm getting $4 million next year. Yeah. All right, all right. We have a great show tonight. Everybody in a good mood? All right, I can feel it. I can feel it. Let's take this opportunity to thank our sponsors. Cisco, New Bedford, where we are right now.
Cisco! Cisco!
Alden Court. Thank you very much to Sharon Jensen. Whaler Inn & Suites, Banquet & Conference Center, J&J Materials, Aaron Pools & Spas, my good friend, attorney John C., fellow barrister, Tomatoes Italian Grill, Mark Petrelia, and this gentleman right here. He's from Bristol County Media, Mr. Aaron Cadju.
Aaron, with two A's, baby.
All right, stand by. We have our first amazing guest, Mr. Dana DeBarros, in just a moment. It's the Paul Santos Live Show. Don't go anywhere! All right, if you're looking in tonight, please type in a message. I'd like to say hello to Lynn Marie Scrivano, looking in from Niagara Falls, New York, one of our big fans. How about that? Barbara Keiss, looking in from Fall River, Massachusetts. And from my hometown here, New Bedford, Mikey Kahn. How about Mikey Kahn? Hey, Mikey, what up, what up? Mike. All right, all right. Let's see. Sandra Soar says hello. She's looking in New Bedford, Massachusetts. Thank you, Sandra.
Where's my friend from England?
The friend from England. That's Andrea Ryan.
Andrea, what are you, Andrea? Yeah. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, we do. We have somebody to watch it from London, England.
I do.
So exciting, so exciting. I don't know. You guys really have to raise your game a little bit. You ready to go? Yeah. All right. He's ready to go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a real, real gentleman. I've known him for a long time, and he is a very, very good singer. And on top of that, just a great gentleman. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the one, the only, Mr. Dana DeBarros.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. That was very kind of you. The song is called How Sweet It Is. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. I needed the shelter of someone's arms. And there you were. I needed someone to understand my ups and downs, and there you were. With sweet love and devotion, deeply touching my emotions. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. Oh yeah, how sweet it is to be loved by you. Feels so fine. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Close my eyes at night, wondering where would I be without you in my life. Everything I did was just a bore. Everywhere I went, seems I've been there before. But you brighten up for me all of my days. With love so sweet in so many ways. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. Oh yeah. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Sugar sometimes. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Whoa. Yeah. To me than I was to myself. For me there is you and there ain't nobody else. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just want to stop and thank you, baby. Oh, yeah, how sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. It's like jelly, baby. How sweet it is. You. It's like honey to the bee, babe. Hey, yeah. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Oh, yeah. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Sarah for Dana DeBarros. That was Sean says we're killing it tonight. Well, thank you, Sean. Leon Monte looking in tonight. Hey, Leon. And Richard Ponce, better known as Big Papa.
Big Papa.
Big Papa in the house. And Grace is coming on the show pretty soon. Somebody that he manages. Bruce Sears looking in tonight. And Lynn Marie, as we said, from Niagara Falls. Okay, this next gentleman is really accomplished. He's somebody that makes films. And wait till you hear his background and some of the people that he knows. Would you please welcome Mr. John Ippolito? Come on down, John. Come on this side so you can grab the other microphone. John Ippolito made it clear that he had to have his own microphone. Step
are
right over
on?
Here.
Are we on?
Are you on?
Well, I'm sorry I'm late.
That's okay.
I apologize.
Step up here so we can see us. There's a monitor right there.
What happened was is my daughter called, my middle daughter, and she said, Dad, are you going to Cisco? Because she knew I was. I said, yes. She goes, I'm right behind you. I said, Mandy, you live 2 hours away. You got to be kidding me. She goes, listen, I'll meet you in the parking lot. I'm right behind you. I couldn't believe it. She goes, it's an emergency. I said, Mandy, what's up? She said, I'll tell you when I get there. All of a sudden, I pull in the parking lot. I'm kind of freaking out. She's 2 hours away. What's going on? There's Mandy's car, and there's a guy driving. She pulls up in front of me. The guy gets out of the car. Mandy stays in the car. I said, what are you doing? He goes, I need to talk to you. I said, you need to talk to me? He said, yeah. I'm her mailman. I deliver her mail. I've known her for 2 weeks. I love her. She loves me. And I am going to marry her and run away and marry her next week. And I said, no, you're not. He goes, yes, I am. He said, I said, no, you're not. He goes, yes, I am. I said, no, you're not. He said, yes, I am. I said, listen, Mr. Mailman, you will not. And I want to talk to my daughter. He goes, no, I'm going to marry her. I said, you will not. He goes, why? I said, why? I'll tell you why, Mr. Mailman. I won't let her.
Oh. Okay. Wait a minute. What happened to the... Who stole my garbage?
Chops. Come on. Come on.
Ooh.
All right.
That was a long way to go there.
All right. What do we got?
Step right up over here. Okay. Hey, this man right here is a filmmaker. And in 2023, this fantastic film is coming out. In fact, I might even have a little bit part in it, right? Tell the folks about this great film.
You do. So we have 8 films, but the film that we're editing right now is on the life of Sib Hashin, who is the drummer from the band Boston.
Wow.
Platinum band. And his son-in-law is The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. And The Rock is in the film. Sammy Hagar is in the film. Doug Flutie. Paul Santos is in the film, interviewing Doug Flutie.
All right, pretty good.
So,
I made the cut.
You did. Wonderful film, and we're really looking forward to it. The premiere will be in May. But before that, we have one in distribution now called 25, Tony Conigliaro, the documentary. So the life of Tony Conigliaro, number 25, from the Red Sox. Fantastic story, tragic, triumph and tragedy of Tony Conigliaro. So, it's kind of neat way we do it. Sarah and myself, and it's kind of a cool little world we're in.
Well, you know, you mentioned the Red Sox. You know, I'm a big Red Sox fan. My father was a Red Sox fan. His father was a Red Sox fan. So the teacher asked me, why are you a Red Sox fan? I'm like, that's for that reason, because my father a Red Sox fan, grandfather a Red Sox fan. So then he said, well, but if your father was an idiot and your grandfather was an idiot, would you be an idiot? I said, no, I'd be a Yankee fan. No. Oh! See that Grace right there? My very good friend. Big Yankee fan. Walks around in stripes during the World Series and all this stuff.
Yeah.
But we love her. We love her just the same.
That's true. Yeah. Yankees suck, by the way.
Yeah. Oh! By the way, speaking of the Yankees, I mean, thinking of the Red Sox. You have some pretty good friends in the Red Sox organization, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we do. I do, but in this film is Rico Petrocelli.
Rico Petrocelli, how about that?
Louis Tiant.
Louis Tiant.
Yep, El Tiante, Jim Lonborg is in this. And then it's a really cool film. One of the films we did, by the way, was on the Celtics, and Satch Sanders was my partner. And in that film, we had the opposition, Willis Reed, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Jerry West and his home, so... It's kind of fun dealing with these guys. Dan Duquette's in the film.
Dan Duquette. Now, you know Dan Duquette? He was the general manager of the Boston Red Sox and the Baltimore Orioles.
Yep.
And, in fact, he helped build that championship team. He did.
He did. Well, we call him the architect. And, in fact, what time we got? Maybe we could call Dan on the phone.
Try calling Dan Duquette?
Let's try. Here's his number. Give him a call. Try him on there. See if he answers.
On this one?
On that one.
On that one. Oh, let me see the number because I screwed up the number.
Oh, you did.
Huh? I did. I screwed up the number.
Oh, you did.
Show it to me.
Let's see if Dan will get an answer here. 9, 7, 8. And let's see if he'll answer. We'll put him right on speaker here.
Hello.
Hey, Dan.
Hey, John, how are you, bud?
I'm doing well. I'm glad you answered. You are now on a radio show. I just told an amazing joke, and I know that you deem me as one of the greatest comedians alive, although this guy next to me thinks he is.
Hey, so, Dan, you're on the Paul Santos Live television show. How about that?
All right.
Hey, you know, when Epstein got there, Epstein got all the credit for building that team that finally won the World Series in 2004. But wait a minute. There's this guy by the name of Dan Duquette who brought in Pedro Martinez, Manny Ramirez, built the whole thing. Isn't that true?
Well, we had a good foundation for that team. And, a lot of those guys were here. They didn't just show up the day John Henry bought the club, you know. That was a great club. We left them a good club in 2002. We had Nomar won the batting title, and Pedro and Derek Lowe won 20 games that year. So they had a good foundation, and then 2003 just missed. That was the AFB game. And then, of course, 2004, they got through. So that was a great year for the Red Sox. And I was so happy all the fans and four generations of my family finally got to see the team win the World Series.
Well, you know, Dan, there's a real good friend of mine in the audience who was a big, big Yankee fan. And when the Red Sox fell behind 3-0, they came back and won 4 in a row. And it was really devastating for us. So can you say anything? Can you just say hello, Grace, please?
Well, you know, how many years did the Yankees win and beat the Red Sox?
That's right.
Barely?
That's
right. Too many.
To win the pennant, okay? And then the Yankees would go on and win the World Series, and we'd be home in October.
That's true.
Watching, you know, the Red Sox, many, many years, were the second-best team in baseball. And, of course, the Yankees, they had a great, great organization.
Yankees haven't won in a little while.
They've won their share, but since 2004, the Red Sox have balanced it out.
Now, by the way, Dan invited me, which was fantastic, but Dan was inducted into the Red Sox Hall of Fame, and along with David Ortiz, and it was something to see. What a night.
Oh, wow.
And thank you for inviting me, Dan, and I know I stole the limelight from you, but it was a wonderful night.
Johnny, I appreciate you being there so we could all celebrate. It was a big night for really my family and all my friends.
Hey, Dan, who's the funniest guy you know?
The funniest guy I know, let me think.
Gary Landerman.
He said that you were going to say him.
The guy sitting next to you, John?
Yeah, John. He said you were going to say him without a doubt.
Well, I do get his jokes. You know,
you're the only one.
Not a lot of
I know the feeling.
I do get most of them.
Yeah. So what are you doing these days, Dan?
I have a consulting business. I have some clients, some institutional clients, some clients in baseball. I got this one really interesting client called Chalkless, and they have a grip enhancement that you can use for all different sports. We did a test for Major League Baseball the past couple of years.
Wow.
To give a better grip to the ball. You can use it in basketball. Some of the football teams are using it. You can use it in golf. But it's a grip enhancement. It's like a sand, and it's at Chalkless Grip. That's pretty interesting, and it's a local company. It's a Wilmington, Mass company, and local guys, and it's pretty interesting material.
Well, my good friend here, Chops Turner, he's a big 49ers fan, so maybe they could give some of that grip to the wide receivers over there.
Well, some of those guys tackling yesterday with their head down, I don't know how they were supposed to do that.
Hey, so Dan, I know you're very good friends with John Ippolito. I also do a sports podcast called Santos on Sports, and perhaps we can get into a little more detail with a lot of your wonderful accomplishments. I know that it was a lot of fun. I actually interviewed you a long time ago. You don't remember, but I'm from New Bedford, and when Brian Rose was pitching, they gave me credentials, and I went up, and we did a little quick interview up in the press box, and you were very, very, very cordial, and it was a lot of fun watching a local kid make the Red Sox.
Yeah, how about that Brian Rose story? I mean, there's a kid that aspired to play for the Red Sox, and he got an opportunity to do it out of high school. And he's still working with the young kids. He used to bring teams out to my camp as some of the kids that he was teaching how to play ball down there.
Nice. That's fantastic. We always like to hear positive stories like that. Hey, Dan, we really, really appreciate. You got one more question. All right, one more ago.
Tell Paul a little bit in the audience about the film, Tony Conigliaro. Oh, yeah, yeah. Your take on that. I know you were a great guest of ours for that, but just a little bit about the film from your perspective.
Well, you know, John and Sarah, they did a bang-up job with this Tony C. I think it's like a more of a documentary. And they got the perspective of Tony from his teammates that played with him, Jim Lomborg, Rico Petrocelli, and Louis Tiant. And, you know, Tony C is a great story for the kids from New England that want to grow up to be Red Sox players. I mean, here's a guy that had the start of a storybook career, hitting more home runs than anybody else in the history of the Major League, fastest to 100. And he got a chance to, you know, showcase his great drive and strength with the team. And then for him to overcome the obstacles that he overcame to continue his career after the tragic accident he had, it's a very inspiring movie. But John and his crew did a great job. And I loved the story of the New England kid that you know, stood tall in Fenway Park and made a huge impact on the hometown team.
100%. Hey, Dan, we really appreciate you taking this call, and hopefully you can reach out and do that podcast a little bit later on. Thanks so much, and
right.
Congratulations for your great career.
Thanks a lot,
Dan
guys.
Duquette, thanks, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wow. Who else you got on that phone?
That's great.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, a great filmmaker. We'll have him back again. This man's career, we could talk to him for an hour, but we got to get to our next guest. John Ippolito, filmmaker, thank you so much. We'll be right back with Lexi Tavs in just a moment. Don't go anywhere. Gary Langevin and the Paul Santos Live Band featuring Artie DeMello. You guys are awesome. All right, let's get back to some music. This young lady is only 22 years old, but she is an outstanding singer. She really, really has some talent. Would you please welcome Ms. Lexi Tavs?
I and think about where I went wrong. The more I do, the less I know. And I know I have a fickle heart and a bitterness and a wandering eye and a heaviness in my head. But don't you remember? Don't you remember? Babe, please remember me once more. I gave you the space so you could breathe. I kept my distance so you would be free. In hopes that you'd find the missing piece that bring you back to me.
For coming down tonight. All right, let's learn a little bit about you. Where did you go to high school?
I went to New Haven High School.
Right, and any, you know, education after that?
Yes, I was at UMass Dartmouth. I went for nursing, so I'm a nurse.
Oh, wow, a nurse. And do you work in any particular... Hey, let's hear it for the nurses. Do you work in a hospital?
Yes, I work at St. Luke's. I'm a maternity nurse.
Oh, maternity nurse. Wow. Yeah, my daughter-in-law delivered up there in Boston. So exciting. And I forgot how small babies are when a newborn is so tiny.
Very small. They were scary at first, but I'm used to it now.
How long have you been a nurse?
I became a nurse last June.
Oh, no kidding. Wow, that's fantastic. So tell me about the singing. How did this all work into your vocabulary, so to speak?
So I was actually asking my mom about this before I came on, because I knew they were going to ask me about, you know, how do I start singing? And she was telling me that in the sixth grade, I guess I told my parents I was going to do the talent show and I was going to sing a song. And she said, oh, God, okay, I guess they didn't know I could sing. I guess I didn't really know I could sing. And then I sang and I won the talent show.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. Wow.
Then, I started working with Sharon after that because I met her through a mutual friend and she's helped me so much. So
you work with Sharon Jensen, the great vocalist.
Yeah, right? Sharon Jensen. Yes.
Sharon Jensen, ladies and gentlemen. So what kinds of things do you learn from Sharon?
Well, a lot of it that I learned from Sharon was exposure therapy. She taught me how to be a little bit more confident than I was when I started out. She gets a lot of opportunities for me and all the other students, so she's awesome. And she kind of taught me the basics, too. So, you know.
Wow, nice.
Yeah.
You ever think about singing professionally?
I do think about it. It's tough because I don't want to stop being a nurse. So I might follow in Sharon's footsteps and just do like some gigs, you know, like
that'd be nice.
Yeah, nursing during the day, singing at night.
Yeah, wouldn't that be great? I think she'd be awesome. All right. Can we ask you to do another song for us?
Yes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, Lexi Tevz.
Thank you.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze
drifting on by. You know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. No sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me, and I'm feeling good. Oh, I'm feeling so good, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Stars, when you shine, you know how I feel. Scent of the pines, you know how I feel. How freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Great job. You know, that's a great song. I love that Mike Bublé thing, right? Feeling good and all that. Well, you're not the only one that's feeling good. You made everybody in the house feel good with that performance. And keep up the great work, and thank you so much for stopping by our show.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, let's hear it once again for Lexi Thames. All right, well, you know, when our first guest sang, we're trying to work all of our guests in. I heard people saying, one more song, one more song. So you know what? Let's get him to do one more song. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, here's Dana DeBarros. Come on, Dana. Oh, Dana's really ready to go. Check it out, Dana. We weren't sure we'd get that second song in, but after that first one, we're going to get the second song in. There we go. It's Dana.
All right, thank you. Thank you. Download this one.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me. and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for no be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, sister, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean. There is a load that you can't bear, that you can't carry. I'm right up the road. I'll share your load if you just call me. If you need a friend, I'll need a friend. If you need a friend, if you ever need a friend, all you got to do is call me. Oh, call me now. Call me down. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dana DeBarros. Wait a minute. Hey. Before we let you go, I know you for a long time. You're a straight shooter. You're a great guy. But this thing about me, you know, and you really started singing until I was 40 years old and all that. I don't know, Chad. It sounds a little bad. No, really. That's what happened, right?
Well, singing in the shower doesn't count. I'm talking about on stage. I just had to get up the nerve one time and go ahead and do it. You know? It's nerve-wracking standing up here, right? Right, Lexi?
try doing the monologue.
No, that's all you, man.
No, please, try doing the monologue.
No, but you have like such a beautiful tone, and it's just there. I mean, you can practice, and you can get better, but some people just have that tone, and you definitely have it.
Well, that's all God, man. I can't take credit for that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's thank him again. It is Mr. Dana DeBarros. Thanks for coming. All right, Chops Turner's going to close it down in just a moment. Don't go anywhere. Gary Langevin and Artie DeMello. You guys are nice and smooth. Are these guys great band for us here tonight?
Yes, thank you.
Man, it just creates that whole Tonight Show genre thing going on. By the way, we have a special shout out tonight celebrating his 17th birthday. Donald is in the house.
Yes, sir.
Oh, there he is. Right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Donald. And what's the other guy's name back there? What's your name? Jim. And Donald and Jim. Happy birthday to you.
Yeah. Oh, we got two birthdays here tonight, right? Two birthdays here? Wow.
Jim in the back.
Pretty good. That's pretty good. People are celebrating their birthdays with us.
Right.
We're honored to have you here on the night of your birthday.
That's correct.
Thank you so much for being here. Okay. Now we're going to close things down. We call him the sidekick of the century. Yeah. We call him the co-host with cachet. We call him the Sultan of Smooth Delicious. Ladies and gentlemen, world-class vocalist and entertainer, my good friend, Chops Turner. Here he comes. Take it home. Here we go.
Give it up for the great singers out there. I tell you, give it to them. They sound so good. Yeah, my man Dana. Young lady, Smoking. Oh, yeah. Oh, beautiful. For spaciousness. Forever ways of grace. For purple mountains, majesties above the fruit and plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Y'all remember this? Help me out then. Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies. Forever waves of grain. For purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plain. America, sweet America, God shed his grace on thee, and thy good with brotherhood from sea to shine and see. I need everybody to sing that. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and cry thy good with brotherhood from sea to shine.
Chops, come on back up here for a second. We got a couple minutes over here. Let's tell a Chops Turner story. Originally from Providence, but you could have lived anywhere, right? But you came to the Wailing City 30 years ago and you set up shop right here. Why'd you do that?
New Bedford is the city for especially great talent here, like we saw tonight display with Dana and young lady over there. Great talent.
And you know, when you hit that high note, I love it when you hit that high note. I know you're professional, you do it all the time. You have to practice hitting the high note, right?
I practice every day. I don't really practice that much because I'm always out there on the road. But I listen to like people like Sharon, the vocal coach over there. And I work on it every day, every day. Working on the nuances.
I thought it was because the food of the looms are a little tight.
That too.
I'm sorry. I had to get one more in there. I'm sorry about that. Anyway, no, but you're a real great professional. And you sing around the area, right? You do a lot of private parties and things like that.
We do everything. Matter of fact, we're here. We do a lot of, we just started working here. It's a great venue, and we travel all over. We want to thank God first and most of all, because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be standing before you tonight. Yeah. Come on, give yourself a round of applause.
Yeah. Hey, you know, Chops is pretty humble, right? Pretty humble. You know, let me tell you something. He's worked with the Temptations. He's worked with the Stylistics. He's worked with great record producer Maurice Starr, who produced New Kids on the Block and New Edition over the course of the years. So this man has been around. You've been around. And that's why you see that he's so talented. A lot of fun working with people like that.
Man, it's great to work with somebody like that, superstar like Maurice. And Stylistics, Temptations, and the band behind you. Give it up for the Paul Santos band. They're phenomenal, my man Adi, and one and only, my man Gary.
You were listening to all those heavy hitters. I'm glad you slid us in there. That was very nice of you.
Oh, you know that, man. I got to put my brothers in
there. Ladies and gentlemen, world-class vocalist and entertainer, Chops Turner. We'd also like to take the opportunity to thank our guest, who's 22 years old, outstanding singer, Lexi Tevz. We'd like to thank great singer, started when he was 40. I don't know what he's doing his first 40 years. Dana DeBarros. And how about filmmaker John Ippolito? And our special phone call guest, thanks to John Ippolito, former general manager of the Boston Red Sox and the Baltimore Orioles and more, Mr. Dan Duquette. Wow. All right. We have a great show coming up next week. We're going to be back here next Monday night. We're going to have a comic from down the Cape. Bob Giannini is going to be here next week. That'll be a fun show. So I'm Paul Santos for the Paul Santos Live Show. Thank you so much for being here. And thanks to you, our live studio audience. The show will be on Wednesday night, 8 o'clock on Channel 95 locally. And keep an eye out for Sunday mornings, 10:30 on ABC6. Don't forget to laugh and have a great night, everybody. Good night. Thank you.